Good morning, it's Devorah, it's InStory Live, and this morning I want to ask you, what moves you? Meaning, what do you let move you? So, hi Anna, good morning. I'll give you an example. What influences you right when you wake up in the morning? So, it could be everybody else's opinion about what's happening in the world, what's happening to them. That's one way. That happens to me some mornings. I get too, like, sucked in too early. But some mornings, like today, I don't let that happen. And I kind of got back in bed after I got up, you know, just for a little bit. And I, hi, Ramona. And I kind of closed my eyes and I just took that time to kind of go inside and make that higher connection. And that's often when a lot of new ideas come to me, where I feel connected to my creativity, my vision, what's unique to me. And then I was really good and I went and I wrote it all down. hi, Arlene, so nice to see you. And I wrote it all down, and and what it has to do with is, like, Ramona and Anna are already in my year-long amazing InStory Way program, which I just love with all my heart. But I've been thinking for a while of bringing back a little bit of my Spilman story selling side to bring the and integrate it with the deep InStory Way into a training program for entrepreneurs, in particular business owners, to do the deep storytelling work that I teach, but in a more laser focused way. So I'm thinking about that, and you in my morning listening are the ones who always get my early morning secrets, and that's actually something I want to talk about. So I'm thinking of opening up a short-term program. Of course, everyone in InStory already, in my InStory Way year already gets it. Hi, Mary. But called the Story Portal. And I pose, you'll see on my Facebook page, if you go under the video, you'll see that I put out my first thoughts just for my community to say, does this resonate with you? And the reason I'm sharing this with you is I want you to take the time now to make sure you allow your creative inspiration in. Take that time to be creatively inspired and connect to it, like share it, record it and share it with somebody. Ask if it resonates. I have a very deep calling right now to help people who have entrepreneurial businesses to use the deep storytelling work I teach in their businesses. And I started with that and it was amazing, but I really wanted to do my deep life purpose work with people where they're transforming their whole lives and they don't necessarily have businesses. They might, but they don't necessarily have that. So that came to me. And one of the things that I have been seeing so often in the business owners in particular that I work with is that they, and it's not just them, but there's so many of us that have kind of what I would call a secret story. Love you back, Arlene. Let's make time to chat. They have what I call a secret story, meaning a story that's extremely true, authentic, and significant, and sometimes huge, and you never tell it. I'm curious if you have a secret story. And it turns out that there comes a time when that secret story will become uplifting to others and not detrimental to you. And the kind of secret story I'm talking about now is not as much the one of like abuse, that kind of secret story. It's more the magical secret story, like you could always see angels, or you always knew what someone was going to say next, or you were an extraordinary artist or visionary. It's some extraordinary thing. Or in one woman I've worked with, it was a very dramatic story, but she never told it. Like sometimes people have these very dramatic, life-changing, turning point stories and they never tell. And part of the reason people never tell is because there is a point at which those stories, when told, would not be helpful. But here's the thing. there comes a time when you are so much on the other side of that story that it becomes your wisdom. And when you don't share it, you leave out a whole way that people can connect to you. I'm reading a book called Angels in My Hair by Lorna Brynn, and for years she never told that she could see angels. And Ingrid Honkala, who I interviewed, she also could see spirits and guides and angels, and for years and years she never told anyone, and now they both wrote books about it. Someone else I interviewed had a life-changing accident. She was hit by a Mack truck, and it changed the trajectory of her whole life into a whole new area of success, and she never told that story. So I call these turning point stories, and they're really powerful. And often people who want to have like an upstanding and respected position in society think you can't tell those stories, and it turns out it's not true. And the way you know is you can tell the stories of the darkness when you're standing in the light. So when you're on the other side of something, then you can share the wisdom you gained from it. The trick is you need to learn how to do it. So that is my motivation for creating a program that, I know my wacky brain currently wants to call it the Story Portal, but we'll see. that's going to give really powerful influencers the opportunity to start telling these really powerful turning point stories that they're not using in their businesses. Years ago, I did a whole series called The Power of Story, and it was the story of your story. And I interviewed these people on what happened when they finally told those stories and how it catapulted them into not just more success, but more authentic life purpose. So coming back to the very beginning for you listening, it was, do you give yourself some time in the morning to receive inspiration and write it down and share it and follow that? Okay, follow that calling. And then if you are interested, if you have feedback, questions, are interested at all in learning more about how to use your stories, then message me. I would love to, I'm interested to do a little bit of informational interviews with business owners who are interested in this. So that's you. If you're already an InStory, we're going there right away today. We're going into those deep stories. That's what we already do. But I think there are more people out there, especially right now, where we can make an incredible impact with this deep story work. So let me know what you're thinking. Let me know what you're up to in the world and how can I help you? I would love to know. I'm always here cheering people on, nudging you to step forward and share your story. So I hope you're inspired. Write down what inspires you. Reach out to me. Let me know how you're doing. And as always, remember, go out in the world, share your story, live your purpose, and be a blessing. Bye, folks.